Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
That's some perky little music there, isn't it?
Love it.
Absolutely. You know, yeah. It almost makes me look forward to the show.
But, comes that close.
But not quite. How is everybody?
Oh, good, good, good.
So you know what today is? Today's our 101st show. Is that correct?
No, it's 102nd.
Oh. All right.
But I think, Steve, it's your 86th.
No. That's not fair. He hasn't missed that many shows.
Well, Barry, what do you mean?
I mean nothing.
Give the spotlight here. It's the sun is directly.
Yeah, we understand. We understand. But,
you know, what could I do?
I have no idea.
I could come on later.
Pull the shades down.
Yeah. Well, the shade. I have some curtains up.
I see.
But
because I have a sun thing here too. Let me see if I open up this thing, suddenly there'll be sun here. Say that.
See if
is it the same sun?
Spent so much time outside with a spray can, maybe there'd be some ozone up there blocking it.
Actually, that lighting is better now.
That looks really good.
Yes, I thought it's you. You always look professional. You don't sound it, but you
look. I look like a professional model for.
I guess I need my hat to make me professional.
Oh, there you go. A professional. Oh, no, we started.
I thought that was rather clever.
I did too.
And again, I have my bar set low.
That's why we're here. That's what we're doing here. This ain't a limbo contest.
No, it's not.
Ah, so how was People's Week, Barry? You had your 2 minutes of fame, your minute 35 of fame.
Yeah. Did a set at New Talent Night Comedy Works here in Denver, in front of a full, sold out house, and it was a thrill. Yeah, quite a step up.
Cool.
Yeah.
Now, did you actually do this in a house? Or is that just
what that's you call just
the
lingo?
Oh, it's stage parlance.
Holy what? Shit! You fucking play to packed houses. What are you talking about? We all do. Look at us. We're all performers.
Yes.
And we're all packed.
Yeah. We're packing. Yeah.
Yep.
Packed and ready to go.
Yeah.
Well, you know, today's a special day. Tom, could you give me a little bit more of a screen, please?
Like that?
Yes. Today is National Spinach Day.
Is it?
Yes. And as you can see from my chopped-off picture, that's actually Popeye.
Yeah.
But Popeye was, I believe, canceled, so we can't show the top of his head. So he's just Pop. You can't see his eyes.
Was Popeye canceled? I wouldn't be surprised.
But. Yeah, he was canceled. I think I don't quite recall what he was canceled for, though.
All the racist overtones, you mean?
Him? Popeye?
I don't know.
No. Well, blow me down. I mean, I don't think so. was Popeye a racist?
I don't think so.
Trying to start a rumor, you know.
Oh.
I don't think he was. I don't think he was. He was shit, look at that. He's eating soul food. How could he be a racist?
So what, help me remember now. Was he married to Olive Oil, or were they just kind of dating?
I think they were. I don't think they were married, because that's why Bluto was always around.
Yeah.
Then what about Sweepy? Whose baby was Sweepy?
That's the thing. Nobody, I don't think that was ever made particularly clear.
What? Who had Sweet Pea?
Yeah, what was Sweet Pea? You know?
Was it like a dumpster baby that they found when he's rummaging around for spinach?
I don't know.
That's a very interesting question. You know, perhaps while, where the audience is being regaled with one of our features, I'll do a little... I'll do a little hunting to see from whence Sweet Pea came besides Olive.
Yeah. Well, we don't even know that it's Olive's kid. Do we? Or did she adopt the kid? This was the 1920s, so you know there were plenty of kids floating around. There was a lot of orphans and shit. You know?
Of course, I think of Charlie Chaplin's kid.
Yeah, there you go.
You know,
there you go.
I just watched
the Charlie Chaplin movie the other night. I don't know what made me do it. I hadn't seen it in ages. Gold Rush.
Yeah, great.
Oh my God, is it good?
Yeah.
Oh, it's not just funny.
Yeah.
It's brilliant.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm watching the special effects, and I still don't know how they did them. Right. I don't know how they did it. I said, how could they have done this? This is incredible. It's brilliant. Really brilliant.
It's like some of those Buster Keaton things that he had done. Like I was always amazed when the barn fell down.
Yeah.
And it just happened to, I mean.
They did that in one take.
Yeah, he did that.
He did that. He stood on his mark, and they did it, and he did it in one take, and everybody else thought he was going to die.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They had to have somebody there that with a protractor and a pencil. And, science.
Yeah.
Protractor.
A coffin. A sextant.
Yeah. A porcelain astrolabe.
Yeah. Porcelain last. You know, if I ever start a band, which I won't, but if I ever do, it's going to be Porcelain Astrolabe.
That is an excellent name.
I don't know. I was thinking about naming this band Barney. Yeah. Rubble already took it.
Yeah.
It's also National Nougat Day, believe it or not.
Nougat. Does anyone even know what nougat is?
It's a kind of candy.
I know, but what is it? What makes a nougat nougat? You know, why is it? Why is it?
Yeah.
I know what chocolate is. You know, but I know what peanut butter is. What the hell is nougat? While you're looking up sweet pea, look up nougat. See if
it's got nuts in it, right?
Does it?
Yeah, and it also
does
has
it.
This, it also has this white mushy stuff around it that kind of holds the nuts in place. It's almost like a colloidal suspension.
Okay.
Really painful. Nougat is a family of confections made with sugar or honey, roasted nuts, whipped egg whites, and sometimes chopped candied fruit.
Right.
Chewy consistency. It's used in candy bars.
Right. Okay. See? Okay. Colloidal I've got that.
Colloidal suspensions are chewy.
I've got that.
There you go, nougat.
There we go. There we are.
History. I want to know about the history.
History of nougat.
Baghdad.
Many legends exist around nougat's origins.
Ah. Do tell.
Wow.
To the parapets.
Some Bukhara in modern Uzbekistan. Wow. That's stunning.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Wow, talk about conversation stoppers.
That's entertainment.
We even stopped a conversation stopper to make a conversation about the conversation stopper. That's incredible.
That stopped the conversation?
It did.
Right.
Wow.
I'll give you $5 to stop this now.
Yeah. What kind of topping you want to put on the word salad?
I'll have a little nougat, please. A little...
What else? What's tomorrow?
Uzbeki nougat. What?
Tomorrow is National Scribble Day.
Scribble?
Scribble.
Not Scrabble, Scribble.
Scribble. You know, more or less like the mental scribbling we do once a week.
Right.
On the show. And it's also National Spanish Paella Day. Paella?
Yeah,
paella.
Really? Yeah. That's a day. That's a good day.
Do you ever have paella?
Oh, hell. Shit. You know how close I live to Miami? You can't avoid it.
What?
They throw it at you as you drive by.
The roads are made out of it, isn't it?
What?
Yeah.
I don't understand. What do you mean?
What do I mean? What do you mean? What do I mean?
What's Miami got to do with paella?
Miami. It's the paella capital of Miami.
Of South Florida. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Lots of great paella down there. My God. And I had a roasted pig down there. You know, they put pig on this bit and they put the roast the pig over the fire.
Unlike eventually, the Bronx where we spit on the pigs.
Eventually the pig dies though, right?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. It does die.
I guess after they rub enough paella over its mouth.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's yeah.
I've only had paella once.
Once.
I've had it often. It's really good.
I've made it many times.
Have you?
I have.
Really? It's lovely. Yeah, they do paella where you are. Yeah.
Paella is everywhere.
Yeah, everywhere. But I mean, like, authentically. I'm sure there's paella in Minneapolis, too, but it's not exactly the same.
Yeah.
Would you care to enlighten me on what the ingredients to a paella are?
Yeah, yeah. Tell us, Barry.
So it's like yellow rice, like, what do you call it, saffron rice?
Yeah, like yellow snow.
Yep. Yeah. And it's just with a lot of little fish things, like mussels and shrimp and scallops and maybe some little bits of vegetables.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Green beans or what have you.
What makes it Spanish?
Well, the key to good paella is making it in a paella pan, which is a wide, flat pan, mm-hmm. little edges. Because you want to get a little bit of crunchiness on the bottom so that mm-hmm. you want to go a little bit, cook it a little bit too long so that it gets crunchy when you scrape it out and it's.
And we have a paella bowl. Yeah. It's like an earthen, like a terracotta paella bowl. It's shaped like that. And then you put the paella in it and then you pop it in the oven to make it even crunchy and then serve it that way. Yeah. This is dull.
This is really dumb. Hey, Steve, you have a world market near you? Cost Plus World Market?
Is there any nougat involved in the... There's no nougat involved in the...
Well, thank you. That was very informative, Barry.
I'm so glad.
Thank you so much. I feel much more at ease because only having it once, I remember that there was fish involved.
Yeah. There's fish involved. Fish get into it.
And a double L. So
yeah. Yeah. In Spain, they call it paella.
Yeah.
They do?
So you can buy these boxes of like, it's like a little kit, paella kit, and it takes like 40 minutes. They just shove it all together in a pan.
I have a 40-minute paella kit. It's called I-95. You get on that, you drive south for 40 minutes, paella.
Paella. The streets are lined with paella.
Lined with paella. And ceviche on the way back up north. Yeah. Well, looking ahead to
and that is a perfect segue.
Is it? Do you think?
Yes.
Okay. Well, good. It's important to look ahead. You know, not too far ahead. Mm-hmm. But you know, you wanna look ahead, right?
It's better than looking behind.
I agree.
Looking at your head.
Or looking at your behind.
Uh huh. Hang on. Let's see if I can do this more smoothly. There we go. Nothing like Glenn Miller.
Who are the people who are most likely to succeed? What's the secret
right
of
here.
Their success?
Jeff Bezos.
Let's see if Nick Baxter can help us find
Oscar
the answer.
Homolka. Nice try.
Hey, Nick, what are you doing?
Nothing. Defrosting a refrigerator. What the hell does it look like I'm doing?
Not right now. You mean to say you're going to stay after school to loaf again?
Uh-huh. This looks awfully familiar.
What are you doing? Oh, reading that article I wrote for the paper. Pretty good, huh?
Why don't I ever get chosen for something like this?
Because you say something.
Most likely to succeed.
Huh.
What have these kids got that I haven't got anyway?
A real necktie?
Did you read the rest of the article? You know, I interviewed these kids and... Well, it was really interesting what they had to tell me.
Hmm.
I can't wait to be the judge of that.
Yeah.
How do I get high grades?
How do I get high?
I'm not going to school just to put in time. I want to be somebody.
You're going to make time.
Instead of a fun, which
is what
I
have.
How do I find time for so many activities? Ooh, I plan for them.
I'm an escort.
I like to make the most of my spare time.
I'm going
to
go get clubbed. And I'm doing
it. Why do I have so many friends?
Because I don't have sleeves.
Well, I like people. I want them to like me.
But for some reason, I'm wearing
a dress. I want to learn how to get along with them better.
I have six.
That will always be important to me.
I have 16 friends.
Now, does that help answer your question?
I still don't exactly see why they were picked.
Well, it seems to me they're all saying pretty much the same thing.
Yeah.
To succeed in something, you have to have a purpose and make plans for reaching it. And work at it all the time.
Oh, my God.
Sounds crazy to me.
Well, what are you doing after graduation?
Graduate.
I'll think about that later.
Are you planning what you'll be doing next semester?
Good night, no.
Why should I? Well, what about next month or next week?
I don't know.
I hate the word
What's
next.
What's the idea?
Well, what are you doing this afternoon?
Nothing. There's nothing to do. If I go home, there'll be homework, or work to do around the house, or something. I'm tired of it.
What a
You do need a purpose and a plan. You should be working on your future.
I don't even know how this shirt got on me.
Have you ever figured out what you'd be like in a few years?
I'll be, like, older?
Why don't you look ahead?
Aw, don't preach at me. Purpose.
I'm reading from the same script.
Plans. Looking ahead.
You got a gun in his hand?
As if you could tell what you'll be like in a few years.
The hell is on that tie?
Or can you?
His lunch?
What about Ed?
He's a gun.
What about Ed?
He'll probably wind up as a scientist. That's what he's aiming for. He studies hard.
Science!
Maybe you can figure that Jean will be pretty active in something. Because she's pretty active now. And... Well, Terry would sure do all right in politics with that knack he has of making friends.
Neck?
Well, I suppose
that neck he has.
Figure out what some people are headed for. But, say, Don.
Yeah?
Suppose you could look ahead like you said.
What would it be?
You figure what I'm going to be like in a few years?
That's not hard.
That's not hard at all.
I'd vote you out. At least
I think they have Carwood attendance yet.
A guy without any purpose or any plan.
You're going to be president of the United States.
Being a drifter. Maybe even a bum.
A bum?
Let's face it, Charlie.
Boy, that was brutal and cold.
I could have been somebody. Instead of a nobody, which is what I am.
I could have been a contender.
You should have stuck up for me, Charlie!
Get him a palooka! You know, when was the last time you saw a good palooka?
They don't make paloocas like they used to.
Yeah. Back then, paloocas were a dime a dozen.
Yeah. They were mostly nougat.
Yeah, even the bubblegum guy, Palooka Joe. What was that for sure?
I think I'll just eat this thing.
The sponge.
That could be me. Nothing but a bum.
Nothing but a bread-eating bum.
What am I saying?
I can tell you right now, acting is not in your future.
There's nothing to all that about purposes and plans and looking ahead. That's book stuff. Just trying to put the old scare in me.
The old scare, huh?
Nice.
Oh, what's that matter? Can't I even build a simple table? I have to figure out how I want it to look and make a plan for building it.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Boy, he could draw a table.
Wow. There. That's the way I want it to look. Now I have to figure out just how to make it.
But I'd like it a little bigger than that.
Width?
Not as flat.
Height?
I'm gonna need lots of paper. a slot.
Really?
I know. I'm gonna work in the prison shop.
While the rest of the kids are playing in an orchestra. In the table.
Wow.
That's better.
What a piece
now
of crap.
Now I've done something the way it ought to be done. It started to shape up as soon as I made these sketches. When I saw how I wanted it to look, and made plans for building it.
This table's gonna burn plans. Real good.
Sketches. Measurements.
What? When I burned that house down.
That's what Don was talking about.
Oh my God!
That's what I have to do with my own future. I've got to
I
look
gotta
ahead
have it.
And imagine. Not what it will be like if I just keep drifting.
Eating bread.
But what I want it to be like. Hello? Oh, hello, Dad. Fine, thanks. How are you and Mother? Great. Say, Dad, you'll want to know. I've been elected chairman of the community club. That's right. Will you and Mother be my guests at the club dinner?
No.
Good. Mary and I will expect you. Yes, I want a future that's something like that. I want to be happy.
I want to sit at a
be
desk.
Be somebody. Have a good job. Friends. A home. A wife and kids. But how do I get there? If that's my purpose, how do I reach it? How?
First, be a white man.
Detailed plans of how to achieve my purpose. And I'd better be getting at it right now. I can write them down. Add to them as I go along. Change them even.
I could erase them when I don't like them.
The important thing is having plans.
It's like a table.
Plans to work with.
Life is a table.
First item, write a list.
Yes, Nick is learning the importance of looking ahead. He's making some decisions about the kind of future he wants and some plans to reach it.
And he's wearing his pants.
Nick wants a happy home life in the future. So he is finding out how his own family works right now, and why it gets along so well. Nick wants a successful vocational life.
Yeah.
So he's getting some idea of the kind of work he wants to do. And he's studying harder to bring his grades up. And Nick wants a rich social life in the future. So he is learning how to get along with people better.
I'm going to be a bouncer.
Because now is the time to start working on the plans you have made to achieve happiness. Having a purpose or goal to plan for has given new meaning to everything that
Nick
does.
Access denied. Access denied.
Hi, Nick. What you doing? Oh, hi, Don. Hey, that sure looks great. Thanks.
Defrosting my refrigerator like you were.
Right. How about playing some ball this afternoon? Boy, I'd like to. But I have a date with a guidance counselor. Want to talk over some different kinds of work in engineering. Then there's the math club meeting. After that, Bill and Ed and I are having a bull session on chemistry. Then I have a date.
Okay.
Nick, who are you?
I've been going places lately.
It's easy, my boy. You've just got to do a little looking ahead.
Oh, boy.
End of film.
Wow. That was
astonishing.
That
was a snore. Astonishing.
I didn't even find that informative.
Maybe I have to look ahead. Maybe it will be someday.
I don't know. That was
poor Nick.
It was pretty disturbing.
Ah. Yeah. Poor Nick.
He grew up to be a serial killer.
Mm-hmm. Well, a serial eater.
So we
miss Alex today, don't we?
Yeah,
sort of.
You wouldn't happen to have a picture of him, would you? There you go.
No.
That's better.
Yeah. Now that's paella.
He looks really.
That screams paella. it does, you know. Oops, now that doesn't work.
He's going to keep his paella up top there? Second story?
I don't know. It could be. Sport. Yeah. Poor Alex. I don't know why. Just poor Alex. Because he can't be here, you know. But we got some cool stuff coming up. In fact, we've got some sports coming up.
Oh, boy. I love
sports. Oh, yeah. Oh, this.
Yeah?
This might be.
The sportiest sport?
This might be. I mean, I don't know. I just took one quick look, and yeah. I was mesmerized. Right. Wow. Mesmerized.
I can't wait.
Anesthetized, one of those things. Hang on.
Steve, what do you know about mesmerization? You know that mesmerize was invented by a guy named Mesmer?
That's true.
What was his first name?
Stephen J.
No, his name was Mesmer.
Knows, you know, everybody knows people's last name. Nobody remembers the first names.
Well, because you're only
Galileo. What was Galileo's first name?
Galileo of Galilei.
Galileo. Mesmer's first name was Franz.
Franz.
Okay, hang on here. Okay, see? In the comics, Sweepy is a baby found on Popeye's doorstep.
Oh.
Actually delivered to him in a box. Popeye adopts and raises him as his son. See, I knew. Did Popeye and olive oil get married? It says sort of, but strictly a marriage of convenience. It was the roaring 20s, my friends.
Yeah, she needed the green card.
Well, let me ask you a question. Who do you think, out of Bluto and Popeye, who do you think was really pork and olive oil?
Well, I don't know. Depends on the Spanish consumption, I would think.
Well, do you think maybe she wasn't pork?
I don't know.
Well, who was pork 20? And spinach?
They didn't have sex in the 20s.
Olive oil.
Nobody had sex in the 20s?
No, that's, yeah.
Wow.
That's why they were roaring.
But we're going to have something better than sex now.
Oh. That could be anything.
Is that sushi?
It could be. But no, we're going to do our sports thing.
Is that it? Is it over?
Oh, there it is.
There we go.
Yes, that's right, my friends. It's what you think it is.
Is that a tug of war?
It's tug of war, and it doesn't get better than this. Are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Call it. You got to call it because here we go.
Okay.
All right, purple versus yellow again.
Yes.
Purple's going for the third win.
Oh, this is the girls against the men?
It's a little hard to say. I think they're all girls, but these days you're really not allowed to say. They've got that rope. They've agreed on the rope.
Yes, they have, and they're tugging.
They're almost tugging. I think they're waiting.
They're waiting for the flag.
Waiting. And there we go. They're
done.
Yeah. That's it. And yes. Oh yeah. There we go.
You got a foot dug in. They're not moving. China's asking whether they want to quit. And they're saying no. It's going on that
Do
rope.
You want? Hang on to the rope or lope, as they say.
That looks fairly pornographic.
They're doing the same thing on the other side, but in the other direction.
Look at that. It would be a lot easier if those other people weren't pulling so hard.
Look at that. That's the angle of injury.
Oh, did you see that? Hang on, we're gonna pause that, and we're gonna go back and see that again in slow motion. There we go. Because it just zips by. If you there, right there.
Are you talking about that Fleeger movie?
No, right there. You see that?
Yeah.
Ah. Yeah, they're holding on to the rope and leaning back.
Oh.
That. And let's move it a little bit forward. Let's look at that. See?
Yeah.
They're still doing that.
Yeah.
And let's just, there we go, a little bit of, and they're still doing it. Okay.
Wow, look at this. They're almost
speeding. Let's go back to normal speed now. There we go.
They actually look like they're, well,
never mind. All right. Yeah.
They're
all right.
Pressing. They're definitely they're inching backwards.
They are.
The team's name is the Heave Hoes.
Heave Hoes.
Is that a heave or a hoe?
Okay. Oh, right there. Okay, let's take a look at that again. Wait. Let's go back. There you go. This is thrilling. Is it paused or are they going? Like, it's impossible
to
tell.
They look like they're going.
They look like they are. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, there we go. Up. Oh, it's impossible to tell if it's paused or if they're... There we go. All right. That ponytail is not helping the second person in line. Yeah. Yeah. You know, they spend hours and hours a day memorizing the path.
Look at that. Look at that. Holy mackerel.
How can you beat that? Look at this.
I think that's known as the string.
I wonder what's happening on the other side of the rope. Oh, look at that. We're seeing what's
happening.
They're getting hauled.
Look at that. You can see they have, they definitely have slide.
Right.
And yes, I think they're a girls' team too.
Yeah. That makes sense. I don't know how you capture this any better. Oh, look at that. They've got the left, right thing going there. They're doing it at the same time. You can't beat the left, right, left, right.
They're going.
Yeah, they're doing what we call alternate foot walking.
I wonder why one gets a tug job.
This is not going to go the distance.
This might happen. This might happen.
This could happen.
Look at the strain.
Oh, no. Oh, well, you look at that now. Well, you see?
The counter. What that guy's saying to them? They're down. They're due up. That's a penalty.
Oh, no. They had the feet thing going. Now they've got the rear end thing going.
Oh, quit dragging your ass. Get going.
They're running out of steam.
And we're nearing the end. We're nearing the end of this.
Listen to that coach.
This is excitement.
Wow.
He's gonna punch her in the face if she doesn't pull harder. What is he saying to them? Other than pull.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know either. Wow.
Well, that was good while it lasted.
Yeah, was it? Yeah. Good gravy.
Speaking of good gravy.
What?
Oh.
I thought you were going to share a recipe or something.
I thought you were going to share a paella recipe.
No, yeah. That only happens in the beginning of the shows.
Okay. Well, we do have to pay a couple bills here, so let's do that real quick. Yeah. Hang on. Let me do that right about now. Hang on. Yeah, we have an idiot in the control booth.
And she heard you.
No, so. No, she's an idiot. She can't hear you.
Your squad is ready for you to lead them through. With Johnny 7 OMA, you charge! Fire grenade! Bullseye for Johnny 7! Watch out, tank! Fire anti-armor shell! Fire anti-tank rocket! Johnny 7's got him on the run! Johnny 7 fires bullets like a rifle! Fires like a Tommy gun! Now it's a cap-firing pistol. You've won with Johnny 7, the one-man army gun. It's seven guns in one. Let's count them. One is a grenade launcher. Two, anti-armor gun. Three, anti-tank gun. Four, bullet-firing rifle. Five, Tommy gun. Six, anti-bunker gun. Seven, cap-firing pistol. There's no other gun like it. To be sure, look for Johnny 7, OMA.
It's his party. Great fun and so easy with such a charming wife. You can see she's thoughtful too. It's proved by the whiteness of his shirt. Look how clean it is. Even the closest close-up look shows it's perfect. Perfect cleanness you get only with Surf.
A couple of years ago at Pete Taylor's dance studio, only Jack smoked L&M's. Now Kim Kelly's come over. When you've got today's best taste in smoking, people find out.
Okay.
I'm all right.
There we go. All right.
Tom, you've had a costume change.
I have. Yeah, if you want to call it that.
Wow.
I'm wearing my Mr. Lee shirt, but we're not at Mr. Lee time just yet. We've got more stuff to do. Naturally. But where are we anyway? Okay, we're doing good. Okay, we're doing great. Well, here's somebody we haven't heard from or seen in a very long time, and it's good to be reminded of where we come from. I think
our roots.
Yeah.
Crud. It's like driving right into the rain.
Going right into the belly of the beast. You know, you can't drive on 836 without it just... There's a waterfall on you. There's just a waterfall.
Well, luckily, Norm, we are Floridians.
Yeah.
We are acclimated to this. We know it. It's like, you know, Alaskans know how to drive in snow.
Yeah. It's second nature.
It is. It's what we are.
I could teach a survival class. Let me tell you something. I could teach a survival class in driving.
Okay, that was
in
the rain.
There's a drop.
Turn on the flashers! Flashers are on!
Okay!
Windshield wipers are on!
Do you have any extra or auxiliary flashers?
I don't have auxiliary flashers! This is a Kia!
This is Florida! We need auxiliary flashers!
I don't have auxiliary flashers!
Okay, well,
I got brights! I got brights! I'll turn on the brights!
Turn on the brights!
I could see everything!
Alright!
Here come more droplets!
Another
Here come more droplets! I'll speed up!
No! Yes! Speed up! Get past
We're gonna beat the rain!
We're gonna beat the rain!
It's raining harder.
It's actually really raining
it's
now.
It's raining so hard.
Stop the car.
Oh, stop.
Stop.
Okay.
Stop.
Okay. It's in park. We're in the middle of the road. It's in park.
We're safe.
We're
in the middle of the road.
In
not
the rain.
Moving with our flashes on.
Oh, God.
Everyone can see us.
Everyone knows we're here. Okay.
Whew. Hey, turn on your flashers and stop, idiot!
Okay, we're safe. We're good. Everything's fine.
Yes. That's a good thing we have emergency flashers.
Yeah.
I mean, if this is not an emergency,
I don't know
what
is an emergency.
Oh, it's raining harder now.
It's raining so much harder.
Back up.
I just...
backup.
Okay.
Okay.
I put it in a brake.
The drivers are swerving all around us.
That's because they can see us. Because we're the safest. We're safe!
We are safe!
We're safe, everybody! We're safe!
Turn and stop!
I just heard thunder. I just heard thunder.
Turn the radio all the way up.
Okay. Damn Lady Gaga.
Shit. I hate this crap. It's better than dying.
That's right, we're safe, and I'm on the edge of glory!
Now that was informative. Boy, I've missed Northern Law.
Me too. I haven't seen them in a long, long time.
They're always Natalie attired.
Yeah, especially Norb or Marv, whoever.
Yeah. Next time you see Natalie, smack her.
Yeah, okay, we'll do that. Okay, so are we ready? I mean, can you be ready? Are we? We're ready.
What are we ready for?
For to be Mr. Lee.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
I don't want to be Mr. Lee.
Well, neither does he, but he sticks to it pretty well. Okay, who goes first? Who's ready?
who's got
their snack thing? Their snack.
Oh, snack. I have some snacks here.
Okay, so no, we just.
All right, so okay. We're gonna do it like we're gonna do a review of snacks the way Mr. Lee does.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Okay, I'm just kind of warming up our audience.
So okay. Yeah, please do.
Today I'm interviewing.
Hang on, before you start.
Oh.
All yours.
So today we're reviewing Justin's classic peanut butter. Justin's made right here in Boulder, Colorado by Justin's Inc., which I think is Latin for incorporated. The ingredients here are dry roasted peanuts and palm oil. Ooh. That way it just slides right off. And what's really interesting, just below the ingredients, it has a little disclaimer, contains peanuts. Yeah. So it's 210 calories, total fat of 18 grams. Let me know if I'm getting into too much detail here, but this is the interesting part. Sodium, 25 milligrams.
Okay.
Total carbs, 6 grams. Mm-hmm. Protein, 7 grams.
Okay.
Trans fat, OMG. Oh, that's 0 milligrams. All right. So this is one of those. See right here, it says this is a knead and squeeze. This snack is on a knead and squeeze basis. So we're going to knead it. I'm trying not to squeeze, just kneading. And then I'm going to squeeze. So there's the fun thing about these is there's no way of opening them. So I'm going to try using all my thumbs and all my fingers to open this thing. I don't know. Is this kneading or squeezing?
I think it's both.
Can you T-bone it?
I think I see a little thing on the back that tells you that you're supposed to cut it.
Yeah, it says tear. It just says tear.
Oh, tear.
Yeah, which is when you really get frustrated with trying to open it, that's where you cry.
Try ripping it there, just for the hell of it.
You mean?
Just, I don't know, just... Yeah, they should be clearer about that. Yeah, you're right.
Are you... You have some kind of a... expert. Okay. And then, there. I don't really see how I'm going to get my spoon in there. But maybe I have to tear it some more. All right. You know what? Not a lot of crack. Not a lot of crunch. But I'm going to just put a pinch between my cheek and gum. Oddly enough, it tastes a little bit like peanut butter.
Does it?
No. So, packaging, zero. Texture, zero. Taste, 1726.
So the final score is that you've given it is what?
Well, you have to multiply the three, right? So
1726.
Times zero times zero.
Which is 1726.
No, I think it's zero.
No, I think anything times zero is still whatever it was.
Was it? Oh.
Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure.
Anything times zero is 1726?
No, it's whatever it was before you said zero, I think. New math.
You lost me. I don't know. Anyway.
All right. Great. So we've got a 1726. Who wants to go next? Steve? Me?
I guess you? I will.
Okay. Hang on. Okay. Hang on. Don't say anything. Wait, you can't go yet. Hang on. Okay.
This looks like a beef jerky stick. I think you would agree with that, would you? It has all of the attributes that a beef jerky stick would have.
Yep.
It's a stick.
Mm-hmm.
It's beef, and I'm jerky. But it's not a beef jerky stick. What it is a Chomps jalapeno turkey jerky stick.
Wow. Wow.
Okay. Real jalapeno, none of that fake jalapeno in here. This is the real McCoy. A Chomps was started in 2012 by Rashida Lee from Chicago, Illinois, and Pete Maldonado from down by you, Tom, Naples, Florida.
Hmm.
And it isn't your average jerky company. Oh, no. As a minority family-owned and operated healthy meat snack brand, their mission is to inspire, educate, and fuel the community with accessible, sustainable, real food that doesn't compromise on taste.
Wow, that's beautiful.
Now, that is a mission statement.
Wow,
that's something that we should all appreciate.
We do.
So let's delve into this a little further.
Are they all made
Don't forget, up? Packaging, texture, and taste. Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. OGT. Packaging, texture, and taste. It says Chomps. And you see, it says good stuff.
Mm.
It's telling you. It's good stuff. And when it tells you that it's good stuff, you know it's good stuff because they wouldn't lie to you. You know, if it was bad stuff, they wouldn't put bad stuff on the front of it.
But Steve, what about the fluff?
They put good stuff. Okay, let's talk about the packaging. Okay, this is about, I'd say, about 2 mil package. It's very, very well sealed. I mean, there's absolutely no cracks because, as you know, air is the enemy. Says here it has 10 grams of protein, only 60 calories, and zero sugar. Once again, that's zero sugar.
Wow.
The big goose egg. Okay, so for somebody on a diet, they could munch one of these bad boys down and there are no carbs, no fat, no taste.
Wow.
But it's good stuff. So let's try and open one. All right, what's under this would you open? I mean, they both kind of look the same. There's really nothing on here that says open here. Hmm.
And try the middle.
It's a stick. Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, that's sneaky.
Wait a minute. Hold
sneaky.
It.
Sneaky.
Hold it. Ah.
Oh, it's the old.
The T-bone switch. Look at that. Look at that. Wow. That is a stick of jerky. That truly is. Now, what do you say we check out the snap? Or is it the crack?
The crack.
Not the crack. Let's check out the crack.
And a thud.
Well, let's check it out again. Ready?
Wow.
All right.
Yeah, I think you lost your strength there.
There's no crack. But that's okay. It's solid. This is solid meat. That's why it doesn't crack. You can't crack solid meat. And you ever see anybody crack a buffalo? You can't, because it's solid meat. You can't crack it. You just can't. All right, let's smell it. Doesn't really smell like anything. Kind of smells like the desk. So we're not gonna, not great, not a great smell, not a great smell. Let's see, what else? As I said, it's what other nourishment values are in here? There's very little salt. There's only 1 milligram of salt. There's absolutely no fats. I mean, it's turkey. How bad could it be? So now the important part, the taste.
Mm-hmm.
Good, Steve.
What the fuck?
You got this.
So, what are you gonna score it?
Kind of bland. So we've got no smell, we have no crack, and no taste.
Mm-hmm.
I'm giving this a 3.
3. Okay, 3. Big 3 on from 0 to 2003. Excellent. Very good. And now it's mine. All right. Where am I? Okay, hang on. Let me just get over here. Kyle's here. He's for some reason disappearing a little bit, so we'll just get rid of that stupid background thing, which we don't need. All right. Great. So last week, hey, my buddy. Last week. If you remember, we tested Publix unsalted dry roasted peanuts, and it turned out that Kyle was extremely peanut allergic and died. That was
sad.
Yeah, that was a sad thing. Who knew? So Kyle's going to help us out this week. This week we're going to. You're gonna love this, buddy. Planters, dry roasted, unsalted peanuts.
Wow.
Yeah. Right. Good stuff.
You must really hate
so
that.
Completely different kind. Let's take a look at the packaging. The packaging is it's got that blue. Not usually great for product, to make your product stand out, that dark blue, but of course it's Planters and they've been using it for years. Planters, the Planters people, let's see, they've been around for a long time. I'm just going to make this up, since 1905, and because peanuts are planted. And there's Mr. Peanut. We all know Mr. Peanut. With the top hat and the monocle. So packaging is not bad. It's air sealed, and you've got this lovely screw top, also blue, and it's got like a stamp of, yeah, you see him, Mr. Peanut. Oh, nice. right there on the top. See that? Yeah, okay. So smells like peanuts. Okay, great. Does smell like peanuts. I'm going to take a couple of peanuts out. There's really no crack involved in these peanuts. They're basically just peanuts. So I'm going to try one. That's good. Yeah, very crunchy. Very peanutty. And how about you, buddy? Yeah, yeah. Just one. Okay. So we'll see if the
did he die again?
I'm not sure.
They are planters.
You always gotta listen to the fingers, Tom.
Either he's dead or your watch stopped.
Yeah. Yeah, that's really sad. That's really sad. Who could have seen that coming? So, but I'm going to give it a good score because, no, I'm still going to give it a good score.
Does the score go up because of his death or?
Yeah, I'm going to give it a 1727. Okay, great. That was great. This isn't that hard to do.
No, I don't know what Mr. Lee's making such a fuss about.
He makes it look so difficult.
You know, it would be wonderful if we can get him back on here so that we can express.
I try. He's a busy man. So we got a minute. How's your week shaping up? Okay. How about you, Barry?
Same.
Yeah. Same with
me.
How
about you?
Same old
mold.
Barry, you doing any stand-up this week?
Yeah, probably.
Good.
I have no plans. I'll do a couple of mics probably.
Are you going to get famous?
No, God, no. I hope not.
Are you going to record any of that stuff so we can show it?
Yeah, I got some recordings.
Why the hell did you send it? Is that why you don't have to do this stupid shit with the peanuts?
Stuff up on Facebook once in a while.
I don't look on Facebook ever.
No, send something funny.
Okay. It's time to go. I'll see you guys.
Zane, baby.
Yeah.
I'll feed freaking Zane, yeah.